Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy VII. Last time we went through the date sequence with Yuffie, and now we head on to the Wutai continent. Wait, what's going on here? Sequence? I guess we're gonna talk before we head into the Wutai continent? Wait. What's up, Yuffie? Didn't get enough of me last night? Yeah, what's up? Oh, so, what, are you from here or something? Better get ready. Well, I'm always ready. After last time, running into that battle without having equipped my materia, I remembered to do it this time! So that's always good. Sneaky. Really tough, huh? Well, I ran into some of the enemies before this point. They weren't all that challenging, even without materia. Oh, crap. How the hell did they follow us all the... Oh, right. Kate Sith. I'm gonna kill that stupid cat! Not them. Who are they after? Yuff, you wouldn't. This one... Oh, okay, now, so... I have a spy from Shinra and Kate Sith, and now I have Yuffie trying to kill me. Yeah, pretty much. You played with Cloud's emotions. He's so distraught over this, he can barely speak. Okay, and we get a battle with weak soldiers, which we'll be able to take out pretty simple. Just use beta. And I thought I equipped everyone. Where are my commands? Aw, stupid sleep status. This is annoying. Let's kill these guys. I guess I forgot to equip people. This kind of sucks. Stop putting me to sleep. Very annoying. Wake me up. Now you die. One more hit. Cloud does some pretty good damage with that normal attack. A lot more than anyone else does. Alright, now let's deal with Yuffie. That little sneaky thief. Yeah, it doesn't matter if you equip any materia for that fight. It's gonna disappear anyway. So that's why I didn't bother equipping it before. Not a lot of point, as far as I'm concerned. Yeah, if you ever noticed all the little sequences where she seemed to be sneaking around with stuff, and especially like right after you recruit her, this is what she was planning the entire time. So, we have to go through this next area with no materia. And I do want to qualify that with a but thou, or, you know, a but, there is another option. Depending on how much materia you have, she can actually fail to steal it all if you have, you know, a whole crap ton of materia. I didn't, so she took all of it. If you have, like, a whole lot of it, like, you know, multiples of each spell, say like three lightnings for each character, or no, one for each character, three in total, and then three of pretty much everything else, then she'll fail to steal some of them. The most likely you'll get left with restore materia, or a lightning, or a fire, or an ice, more than anything else. So those aren't particularly important, especially for this next area. But what you do want for this area is you want to equip for maximum output for physical attacks. So strongest weapons you have, the champion or championship belts, depending on, you know, where you look at them, depending on, you know, I think in the list of prizes in the Gold Saucer, it's listed as a championship belt, and here it's a champion belt, whatever. They give you 32 power or strength and 32 vitality. So ups physical defense and strength, so that's great. The adamant bangles, great defense, definitely want those. Unfortunately, I didn't buy her better weapon when I was at, I think you can get one that's slightly better than this at Cosmo Canyon, but I'm too lazy to go all the way back there. And this is probably your best bet. I think you can get one that's slightly better than this, but I like the high hit percentage, that really helps. Now, to note, this side quest here, this sequence with Yuffie stealing the materia, this can be done at any point on disc 1 or 2. After that, it's no longer available. And once you get on these bridges, you can't run into battles. And you can't leave, you can't go and buy more materia. They won't let you onto your tiny Bronco, so there's that. And, yeah. Ooh, kind of rocked me. Look at that. I'm not pressing the button, and it moved me. Cool. But yeah, you can do this anytime up to the end of disc 2. And what was the other point I wanted to mention? I can't remember. You want to head underneath these bridges in this direction here. Wow, I've gone a long time without a battle. Had to say it. So yeah, the enemies here have a high tendency to drop both battle items and, you know, healing items, like X potions, Phoenix downs, ethers. You can really fill out your inventory of such items at this point, which is very helpful. Also, having someone who's long-ranged, has a long-range weapon, can be very helpful. Doing this with Eris forced into your party is not the best option. Preferably, you would do this prior to this, or even after it. In fact, the next area that we go to, the Temple of the Ancient, features a whole bunch of items that have no materia slots at all, and contain higher attack strength than, I think the Clouds has 70 attack strength, which is a lot. And he'll do quite a bit of damage with that. Plus, it also has a bonus to crit chance, and I think almost everyone gets a weapon like that. I think one person has found one, or one is obtainable, and I think that's Yuffie's prior to, and it's a reward for Fort Condor there, so there's that option if you want. There's another enemy here. Hopefully this is it. Yes, this is it. These are the lightning birds, as far as I'm concerned. Thunderbird, perfect. They use a lightning attack that does about 400 damage to all your people, and this is it. Yeah, that's quite a bit of damage, and that can really hurt you. However, Vincent's limits. That's something else I wanted to go over. Perfect timing. His limits transform him into some monster. And it gives him, I think, about a 30% boost in HP and restores his HP to full. Then he has an option of doing a berserker type attack or that magical attack that he just used. And it can be quite powerful. There we got a bolt plume, which is a weaker one. And some high potions. Those will be useful. How many high potions do I have? Not many. I'm going to want to battle around here a little bit, get a few X potions so that it's not too difficult in the next area, because you will want to use a few X potions. I suggest sticking to the this area. The desert. Well, it's not desert, but whatever this stuff is supposed to be. The other things that are quite useful in this area are right arms. Use a right arm. You can pretty much take out everybody, almost everybody, in one hit. However, you're not going to have a lot of these because they're kind of difficult to obtain. The other thing you can do is you can fight those sea worms in the Medeal area from before and get a whole bunch of, what are those things? Of dragon scales, which can use the Aqualung enemy skill, and it's quite powerful, especially when you have nothing. So anyway, I'm going to battle around, get a few X potions, and I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. I got a bunch. I just battled around for like 10 minutes there. Little minor grinding, kind of, I guess. Not that I needed the grinding, I just needed the items. So. And one more battle before we get in there. Why not? What do we got here? Same enemies we've seen before. I'll keep that. I don't need to use that right now. Might as well keep that. I can probably one-shot the boss of this area with Cloud's Limit. I'm sure I'll use it prior to then. I'll just use it in the start of a battle where that's more important than this. These guys don't do a lot of damage. I'm not too worried about them. There we go. Yeah, they tend to give out Phoenix Downs. Those little yellow bugs seem to give out the X potions more than anyone else. Anyway, we enter the village of Wutai. And there's Yuffie just standing there waiting for us. Let's chase after her. What have we got in here? Ah, the weapon shop. No, never mind. What? Entirely sold out. The wall is just lined with weapons. Some are big enough that even Cloud could use them. A sample. Well, I'll take a sample, even if it is used. It's probably better than what I'm using. Yeah, they won't sell anything to us right now, which is kind of unfortunate. Here we have the Turtle's Paradise notice. And right next to it, obviously, is the Turtle's Paradise. This is not one of the flyers that we've been finding. This just explains if we find all six, we can win a prize. And we've found 5 of 6 at this point. Ooh, what are you doing here? Oh, so there's no materia left. Well, that sucks. Let's talk to you here. What do you have to buy? Luckily, this place hasn't been, they'll actually sell us stuff. That's nice. What do we got here? Fire Veals and Swift Bolts. These are the level 3 battle items. And I'll just pick up, I think, about 5 of each. Just so I have quick ways of taking out enemies if I need to. Probably won't, but anyway, there's that. And where did little Miss Yuffie go? All he does is sleep. Oh. So let's talk to Yuffie. Or let's talk to Godo, who's Yuffie's father. See if we can find Yuffie. This is Godo's house. And in here, luckily enough, we get free resting point. Yay! This is one way you can make use of grinding outside if you're finding the boss too difficult without materia, because you're not going to get it back prior to the next boss. However, haha, secret passage. Awesome. What do we got here? A magic shuriken. I wonder who that could possibly be for. Alright, let's head through here. And that wall definitely does not belong there. Let's go through the very not secret passage. And we get a hairpin, which is a long-range weapon for Red 13 if you care to use it. Though I believe his Seraph Comb is still stronger. Alright, let's talk to this guy here. Go rest yourselves. Okay. Never heard of her. But you're supposed to be his father. You don't know her, huh? Okay. Oh, so we're getting kicked out of here, too. Hey! Yuffie! What's going on here? Yeah, well, if we're the ones really fighting and you obviously don't like them, why did you steal my materia? Apparently, there's some dissension between Yuffie and her father, eh? Style? Dictate? Fancy words! I don't know how to look at this line. The obvious interpretation, at least to me, is that because this is supposed to be more of a backwards kind of town, well, not really backwards, but it definitely has a Japanese feel to it, and contemporary. It's not a contemporary Japanese house, it's more of a traditional Japanese house, which makes it seem more backwards, I guess, and especially in the eyes of Westerners, I guess. It almost seems like he's using that kind of a backwards feel to vibrate uncontrollably there on the screen. No. Kind of uses that as a basis for his sexist ideas here. You know, a daughter using fancy words is kind of like an educated daughter. And he's talking down to her for being educated. At least that's how I read into it. And she gets chased out. Alright, what do you got to say? Nothing? Does he say anything after this? Talk to me. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, you can run up here. I don't think Yuffie's even here, though. No, nobody's here. That's one sequence that you can show off. You don't even have to do that sequence. But if you do that sequence, then, I don't know, it just kind of gives background on Yuffie, and I find it's quite interesting. Especially considering what we'll see of Goto later. Now, does that trigger this sequence? No. In order to trigger that sequence, and basically that's the next place we'll see Yuffie, I think you have to go here. Aha! The Turks. Okay, it's... Oh crap, boss time without materia? I don't want to deal with this. Good thing I bought those battle items, I guess. Be able to target all three of them at once. Well, yeah, we already knew that. Yes, what the hell are you guys doing out here? Oh, so they're on vacation. And these guys are far too lazy to want to even fight us now. Rude gets one line, complains about the booze. Really, Rude? So yeah, there's no boss fight here. We just get to see these morons on break. Pretty much all we can do there. Now I believe that triggers this sequence here. I could be wrong. Yeah. It moves this lady off the treasure chest. Yeah, and she still says the same thing here. Anyway, let's open this chest here. Ah, some materia. It's support materia, and it's stolen. Of course, it wouldn't be very useful to us, considering it needs to be paired with anything to do anything. So, yeah, it wouldn't have been all that useful, even if we had been able to keep it. Next area we can check out is this house. More weirdos. I wonder if there's other people here. I've never seen you before in my life. Gotta love how they put a line in there to, I don't know, poke fun at the fact that in JRPGs you always just wander into people's houses and go through their drawers, and in Tifa's case, you steal her underwear. Strange looking girl, huh? Wonder. Peekaboo! Found you. Whoa, she's fast. Anyway, that's the next sequence. The two houses up there we'll end up seeing later. There's nothing we can do there for now. Go over here, though. Ooh, that's not too inconspicuous, is it? Let's guard the gates, yeah. There's no chance of her getting out now. And just hit the circle button to pound on this, even though that would break his fist. And the rest of this plays out automatically. Cornered. Materia for me, none for you. Okay. And here are some Shinra soldiers. Are they after me? Nope, apparently they're gonna go talk to these guys, the Turks. Sephiroth, I guess, eh? Because they've been chasing Sephiroth the entire game, just like we have. What a drag. Shikamaru's line. Oh, yeah, so they're too lazy to do anything. Looking at you is making me suffer. Oh, that's a bad thing. better pound a couple more back then. Yeah, when they're not on vacation. Yeah, good luck with that. You guys go after Sephiroth, you're gonna get impaled by a longsword. Yeah, whatever. We get more money than you taking our vacations. We're on vacation, we get our vacation pay, we're making more than you do in a week. Don't misunderstand. And I agree with Reno wholeheartedly here. Rude doesn't like to say anything. And Elena, or Elena, is peacing the hell out. And she's gonna go, I guess, help the soldiers. Anyway. Stored it in a safe place. Well, we're gonna have to get the that materia back from her next time, because I'm probably running a little long here. So, anyway. First, the last Turtle's Paradise, so we can go pick up that reward next time. Anyway, that's all the time I have for this episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy VII. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time.